Let's spend a few minutes and talk about making homelessness worse by helping, which is essentially just one more example of pogos. We have met the enemy and he is us. Given that the number of homeless people on the street seems to be growing on an ongoing basis, the typical response to the situation is to provide temporary shelters because of the realization that the temporary shelters will, in fact, provide shelter for the homeless people and get them off of the street. The provide shelters, it happens because some people honestly care about doing something for the homeless people, and other people are more interested in doing something for themselves because having homelessness people on the street isn't good for business wherever they happen to be on the street. Though the treating homeless people on the street by providing shelters is simply treating the symptoms. And the one thing that we have learned over time is the more you treat the symptoms, the more symptoms that you will have as time evolves. Putting band-aids on kids' knees doesn't keep them from falling off bicycles. You need to do something that is actually developmental so that a longer-term solution for homeless people on the street is actually housing and jobs so that they have an income to be able to pay for housing on an ongoing basis so they don't, so they're not homeless people. Though this is a much longer term solution, and because it's a longer term solution, the typical response or the most appropriate response is that you have to do one and the other at the same time. You have to implement the short-term fix as you're pursuing the longer-term solution. The difficulty that arises, though, is that by providing temporary shelters actually decreases the visibility of homelessness that tends to diminish the awareness or understanding that the longer-term solution is actually needed. So if you provide shelters for the homeless people, so people don't see or recognize the homeless people, they don't realize the need for jobs and critical services and housing, so that these people are no longer homeless, which just helps in ensuring that the more temporary shelters you provide, the more you will need to provide. Now, to make the situation even worse, the funders, I mean, temporary shelters are not free. Funding has to come from somewhere, and typically the funders are very short-term focused and want short-term success. So they provide funds to people that look like they're creating success, which is getting homeless people off the street. So they provide funding to people who create temporary shelters that creates fragmentation and competition and lack of knowledge and understanding, which further diminishes the likelihood that the longer-term solution will actually be pursued. And there's one more critical relationship here, and that is really a catch-22 in that homeless people on the street create barriers produced simply because they're homeless, which makes it more difficult to access resources, which diminishes the likelihood of the longer-term solution. And we have a vicious reinforcing loop, which essentially says you can't get housing because you don't have housing. So the whole set of relationships sort of should provide a sense that it's not a situation that for which there is a single one-dimensional answer that solves the problem. There are multiple things that have to be pursued concurrently if the problem is really to be addressed. Now, this whole set of relationships was actually repurposed from a systemic approach to ending homelessness by David Peter Stroh and Michael Goodman, which is a marvelous paper, and I recommend that you read it. Though I think that there's really a glaring omission from this set of relationships, and I would ask you to think about it and comment as to what you come up with in terms of what's really missing as an essential component of this set of relationships to address the situation. Hope you found this meaningful, and I'll see you in another perspective soon. Bye.